In a previous video, we saw how we could set up a system of linear equations that would solve lights out. And for the 3x3 version, the system in matrix form would look like this. Recall that each column represents the action of pressing the corresponding square. So if you look at column 1, it corresponds to pressing square 1, which is the top left square. And the squares that are affected are square 1, square 2, and square 4. Those entries that have the value 1 in the column. So we're trying to solve this system where the right-hand side B values correspond to the configuration of lights. In this case, squares 2, 4, 5, 7, and 8 have their lights on. So B2, B4, B5, B7, B8 will have value 1, and the rest will be 0. So we're going to solve this system using row reduction. It will solve it for the general values B1 up to B9. So I'm not going to fix them to a particular set of values. So what that means is, at the end, I will have solved 3x3 version of lights out for all possible configuration of values. And you might find that after watching this video, all the fun of playing this game will have been taken away. So let me go ahead, and I'm going to form the augmented matrix. And I have left some extra space on the rightmost column, because this column is going to get big. Let me move this lights out of the way. And what we're going to do is add row 1 to row 2. So row 2 is replaced with row 2 plus row 1. And remember that this system is over GF2, so 1 plus 1 is 0. So if I add row 1 to row 2, I get 0 here, 0 here, 1 here, and B1 plus B2 over here. Now, the next operation that I'm going to perform is to replace row 1 with row 1 plus row 4. And that will give me 0 here, and a 0 here, a 1 here, and a 1 here. And this will be B1 plus B4. Alright, now the next operations that we're going to perform are the following. I'm going to replace row 3 with row 3 plus row 1. And replace row 5 with row 5 plus row 1. Okay, so I'm adding row 1 to row 3 and row 5 as well. So if I add it to row 3, this will become 0, this will become 1, and that will become 1. And over here, I will have B1 plus B3 plus B4. And if I add row 1 to row 5, this will be 0, and this here will be 0, this will be 1. And this will be now B1 plus B4. Plus B5. Now, the next operations that we're going to perform are replacing row 2 with row 2 plus row 3 and replace row 6 with row 6 plus row 3. So I'm adding row 3 to row 2 and row 6. And adding row 3 to row 2 will give me 0 here, a 0 here, a 1 here, and a 1 here. And now I have to add the right-hand sides. So B1 plus B1 becomes 0. So I'm left with B2 plus B3 plus B4. And now adding row 3 to row 6. So row 6 is down here. I get 0 here, 0 here, 0 here, and 1 here. And I get B1 plus B3 plus B4 plus B6 on the right-hand side. The next operations that we're going to do is I'm going to take row 7 and add it to rows 2, 4, and 5. All right, so that will clear the ones up here. And adding row 7 to row 2, I have 0 here and 0 here. And a 1 here. And this will just add B7 to the right hand side. Now adding row 7 to row 4, I have a 0 here, a 0 here, and a 1 here. And that will add B7 to the right-hand side. And finally, adding row 7 to row 5, I get a 0 here, a 0 here, and a 0 here. And we'll have to add B7 to the right-hand side. Now, one nice thing about row 5 is it already tells you that X6 has to be equal to B1 plus B4 plus B5 plus B7. So we have successfully isolated one variable. And let's continue. So the next operations that we're going to perform are replacing row 1 with row 1 plus row 8, row 3 with row 3 plus row 8, and row 4 with row 4 plus row 8. So if we do that, we'll clear out all the ones here. So row 8 added to row 1 will give me 0 here, and a 0 here, a 1 and a 1 here. And I will have to add B8 to the right hand side. Now if I add row 8 to row 3, I get a 0 here, I get a 0 here, and I get a 1 and a 1 here. And I have to add B8 to the right hand side. And finally, adding row 8 to row 4 will give me a 0 here, a 1 here, a 0 here, and a 1 here. And B8 is added to the right hand side. So let's move on to the next column. And this time I'm going to use row 5 and add it to rows 2, 3, and 9. So row 2 is replaced by row 2 plus row 5. Row 3 is replaced with row 3 plus row 5. And row 9 is replaced with row 9 plus row 5. So adding row 5 to row 2, I get a 0 here, and everything else stays the same. Now row 5 added to row 2 will have a B1, a B2, a B3. Now B4 goes away, B5, and B7 goes away. So I have a B1 plus B2 plus B3 plus B5. And that will be my right hand side. Now adding row 5 to row 3, we get 0 here, and everything else stays the same. Now B1 and B4 go away. And so we're left with B3 plus B5 plus B7 plus B8. And now adding row 5 to row 9, I get a 0 here. Everything else stays the same. And I'm going to have B1 plus B4 plus B5 plus B7 plus B9 on the right-hand side. Now we're going to add row 6 to rows 4, 7, and 8. So row 6 added to row 4 will give me 0 and 0 up here. And I will have a B1, a B3, B4 will be gone, but B6, B7, and B8 will appear on the right-hand side as well. So B1 plus B3 plus B6 plus B7 plus B8. And now adding row 6 to row 7, I get 0 here and 1 here. And that will give me B1 plus B3 plus B4 plus B6 plus B7 on the right-hand side. And now adding row 6 to row 8, I get a 0 here and a 0 here. And the right-hand side will have B1 plus B3 plus B4 plus B6 plus B8. Now we are going to add row 9 to row 1, to row 3, and to row 7. So adding row 9 to row 1 will give me zeros up here. And now B1, B4 will go away. So what's left is B5, B7, B8, and B9. I think row 9 to row 3 will give me zeros here. So what we'll have is B1 plus B3 plus B4 plus B8 plus B9. And adding row 9 to row 7, this will turn to zeros. And B1 and B4 and B7 will go away. So I'll have B3 plus B5 plus B6 plus B9. And now I'm going to add row 2 to row 8 and row 2 to row 9. That will clear out the ones here. So adding row 2 to row 8 will give me 0 here. And B1 and B3 will be gone. So I will have B2 plus B4 plus B5 plus B6 plus B8. And adding row 2 to row 9 will give me a 0 here. And B1 will be gone. B2, B3 will be here. And B5 will be gone as well. So that will give me B2 plus B3 plus B4 plus B7 plus B9. And finally, I'm going to add row 9 to row 6. So doing that will give me 0 here. And B3 and B4 will go away. So I will have B1 plus B2 plus B6 plus B7. Plus B9 on the right hand side. Now if you look at this matrix, every column has exactly 1, 1, and the rest of the entries are 0. And the same goes for every row. From this, we can actually write down the solution. So x1 will have to be given by b1 plus b3 plus b6 plus b7 plus b8. x2 will have to be given by b5 plus b7 plus b8 plus b9. And x3 will be given by b1 plus b3 plus b4 plus b8 plus b9, and so on. So we can actually read out the solution for x1 up to x9. And let's do that. Let's write out x1 up to x9 in terms of these b's. And I'll have to make this a little smaller. So x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6, x7, x8, x9 will be equal to. So x1 will be b1 plus b3 plus b6 plus b7 plus b8. x2 will be b5 plus b7 plus b8 plus b9. x3 is b1 plus B3 plus B4 plus B8 plus B9. X4 is B3 plus B5 plus B6 plus B9. X5 is B2 plus B4 plus B5 plus B6 plus B8. And x6 is b1 plus b4 plus b5 plus b7. x7 is b1 plus b2 plus b6 plus b7 plus b9. And b8 is b1 plus b2 plus b3 plus B5. And finally, x9 is b2 plus b3 plus b4 plus b7 plus b9. Okay, so that's the solution in terms of the b's. Now let's bring back this configuration of lights here. In this configuration, I have B2 equal B4 equal B5 equal B7 equals B8 equals 1. And the rest are zeros. So we just have to plug it in and see what the solution is. Okay, so if you look at the solution, I have to press square 2, square 4, square 6, and square 9. So square 2, square 4, square 6, and square 9. And as you see, I have solved the puzzle. So there you go. I have solved 3x3 lights out completely. No matter what configuration of lights you give me, I can tell you, using this solution here, which squares you need to press in order to solve the puzzle. Now, I encourage you to try this with a 4x4 board. And you will notice something rather interesting if you go through all the work. Clearly, you have to do more work, but it's not impossible. And after a couple of hours, you will have a solution, and you have totally demystified the game. Good luck.